world, it's the church, the gathering together, ekklesia, the coming together of the believers for the purpose of worship. Over and over again we say that it's our work to come here and to offer prayer, to offer songs, joy, repentance, thanksgiving, giving thanks to Almighty God for all that He has given us. The duty that Adam and Eve were commissioned to do in the Garden of Eden. That's what they were to do. They were to rise up in prayer and thanksgiving to the God, the Creator of us all. And that's what we're called to do. And we begin now the pre-Lenten Sundays. We don't rush into things. We gradually go into today with the Sunday of the tax collector and the Pharisee. The tax collectors were called publicans because they were public sinners. They didn't try to hide what they did. They were extortioners, as the Pharisee calls them. They were bad people in some kind of a strange way that people could label people bad, you know? And that's probably the point, the main point of the gospel lesson today, that it's not up to us to label other people. It's not up to us to thank God that we're not like the rest of men, and the rest of men like this tax collector here. I am not like other men, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even like this tax collector, working for the hated Roman occupiers of the Holy Land, collecting the taxes that Caesar would impose upon them, and telling them whatever figure he wanted to tell them, and take off the top of it, whatever over and above he extorted, over and above the Roman tax. This is how the tax collectors got wealthy. A couple Sundays ago, we read the gospel of a real live tax collector, a publican, Zacchaeus, who had a desire to change things, to repent, to turn things around. In order to do it, he couldn't see Jesus because he was so short. He had to climb up into a tree in order to see Jesus. But that was the kind of desire that drove him to repent and to confess, as he does confess when Jesus goes to his house. And he tells all the things that he's doing in repentance, paying back what he has extorted fourfold, not just double, but four times what I extorted. Half of my goods I'm going to give to the poor. Half of it. Some of us whine a little bit, don't we, when we're asked to give 10% of our stuff, our possessions, 10% to the work of God, and that's a little high, Father. cut that perhaps in half. So anyway, it's not up to us, like this Pharisee takes upon himself to judge the rest of the world, and in that judgment to set himself apart from that world. And that's really the tragedy here. The real tragedy of the Pharisee isn't so much the hypocrisy, because he does all this stuff openly. He fasts twice a week, and he gives a tenth of his earnings to the church and all of that sort of stuff. I fast twice a week, I give tithes and all that. Well, yes, that's what the law of the Jewish faith said you had to do. In other words, you just paid your tithe, you paid your dues in the temple, right? No. And here you are asking God to somehow or another pat you on the back for doing what you're required to do. Somebody has to pay for the upkeep of the temple. Somebody has to pay the well-salaried priests and high priests and all that. The theme of today's lesson is Father Schmemann, the great theologian of our faith, said, the lesson is humility. God himself is humble. Strange paradox. Our Lord, you know, God incarnate, says, follow me, for I am meek and humble in heart. I'm the model, says Christ. Meekness. Humility. Neither of which we see in the speech of the Pharisee. On the other hand, we have the tax collector who stands afar off, sort of at the door of the church, the temple. The Pharisee, of course, went straight up to the front. It's right up. But the publican is back there, just inside the door, feeling terribly unworthy. It says, as he beats his breast, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Be merciful. What we pray over and over again in church, don't we? Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. In many different languages. Kyrie eleison in Greek. Hospodi pomiloi in the Byzantine chants, the Slavonic. Hospodi pomiloi. Lord, have mercy. God, be merciful to me, a sinner. And from this model, the church from the early days, in the early days of the monks in the desert in the fourth century, took these words and incorporated them into the Jesus prayer, which we say over and over and over again in our daily lives. Whenever we have a moment and we need to pray, we pray the Jesus prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Have mercy on me. I'm not going to talk a long time this morning because we know the gospel of the publican and the Pharisee. We've had quite a good surprise this morning. I was dying to tell all about it, but I had to go around about the bush because I gave my word I wouldn't. But we brought a fine young man into the catechumenate. And it's more than fitting that we do it at this day during the time after the feast of the presentation of our Lord in the temple. It was 40 days after the birth of the child, according to the Hebraic law, they brought the child to the temple and offered the child to God to enroll him in the list of the faithful. So today, I think, is very, very touching to me, at least, that Corbinius's mother came with him to present him to the temple as a catechumen. There is a St. Corbin. Has an IUS at the end of it, but we've got our Corbin. As the Virgin Mary brought Christ child to the temple and presented him 40 days after his birth, 40 days after Christmas. Beloved ones, let us try more and more in our lives to be as humble as we can. You know, humility isn't a groveling in the ground all the time. It comes from the word humus, which is ground. But after all, we came from the ground. We came from the clay of the earth. And so we've got quite a bit to be humble about. But basically and theologically, humility is admitting what is. Admitting what is. that's how we can say that God is humble. Because God knows who he is. I am. And that's what we need to say. That's what we need to know. That I am a Christian. And I am becoming more and more and more like God. Because I was created in God's likeness. I'll never become God. No, 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 no. That was Satan's sin. He was envious of God. We won't become God, but we'll become more and more and more like him unto eternity. And how will we do that? By admitting what is. Welcome to our little community, Corbin. We're looking forward to a long and joyous catechumen for you. Amen.